Hey guys, this is Hassan from gearuphiking.com, and in this quick video I'm going to unbox and review the Unigear 10 liter dry bag. Here it is, here how it looks like. It comes in a convenient plastic bag. Let's quickly pull it out so you can see it. I suppose that this is the shoulder strap. It has a single shoulder strap. This is the fully waterproof smartphone pouch that I'll be definitely using. Let's first see the waterproof smartphone pouch. It's some kind of a small strap here. So this is how it looks like. Pretty dope, right? Your smartphone is protected. Just you put it inside and then you clip those buttons here. Pretty dope actually, I like that. I didn't expect it to have a waterproof smartphone pouch, and it's a nice perk. As for the dry bag, here it is, guys. It comes in my favorite blue color. It's the summer color. Ooh, it's nice. It's nice. It looks bigger than I expected, at least. There's a logo. I really like the color. It's pretty nice. And in front, here in front, you have some instructions how to use the dry bag. Because for folks that haven't used a dry bag, it's not as intuitive. This is it. It uses a rolltop closure, as I said. You have the instructions in English here. These are the tags. Unigear. Smells good. Here it is. It's pretty sturdy, actually. All dry bags use a rugged PVC material. This one uses 500D polyester and has a waterproof rating of IP X8, meaning that you can submerge the dry bag for short periods, for like 10 minutes or so, without risking for your belongings to get wet, which is pretty cool, right? Yeah, it's pretty roomy. It has only one. See, you have a one big opening here with a roll top closure. No internal dividers inside, no surprise here. I have used only one or two dry bags that have internal dividers and internal pouches. It looks really, really sturdy. This is how it looks like. Once again, I'm going to turn it open on. Here it is. It looks stylish, right? So I got myself the 10 liter dry bag because this is what I need. I need just that, a small dry bag for my hikes when I cross rivers or when I have to swim on beach trails. But in case you need to stuff it with other stuff, to pack it with other stuff, you can also get the 20, 30 and the 40 liters, because Unigear have those volumes too, which is pretty convenient if you need to pack more stuff. In the next few days I'm going to test this dry bag. Actually, I'm going to test it on two hikes. First I'm going to do a waterfall hike, and then I'm going to do a beach hike on a beach trail. This buddy will see water, that's for sure. Before I go to test the dry bag on the field, I like to test them at home, because I like to be 100% sure that my belongings will stay dry no matter what. So what I'm gonna do in a minute is I'm going to just pack this buddy with some clothes, and then I'm going to submerge it in a bucket full of water to see how waterproof it is exactly. What's up, everybody? Here I am back again. So as promised, I just loaded my dry bag with a lot of clothes. Actually, I was pretty surprised once again. Before I use this bucket of water to submerge the dry bag in, I'm going to just show you guys how to put on the shoulder strap. Super easy, actually. Sure enough, you don't need a science degree to do it. So we have three gear loops, one here, and one over here. So you attach one of the ends of the shoulder strap to one of the gear loops, and the other end of the shoulder strap you attach to this gear loop. So I'm going to do this. And voila, we have a dry bag with a single shoulder strap. I like to, you can wear it like this, or if you're like me, I like to wear those like this because it's more stable. And I can do drilling, you know. So that's it. It looks very nice. It's pretty comfortable. Yeah, this is super lightweight, very easy to carry and to transport. This is how it looks like. Once again, the material is super sturdy. It's tear and abrasion resistant, besides being fully waterproof.
in a minute I'm going to just put it in the bucket. Luckily my wife is not at home because I'm going to do some water spinning now, I'm pretty sure of it. Are you ready? Are you ready? Let's see how waterproof this buddy is exactly. Okay, now it's fully submerged underwater. Let's see. Let's stay for another 10 seconds or so, just to be sure that I'm doing the test okay. Okay, let's pull it off, that's enough. It's a little mess here. Don't tell anyone. But my family at least. So, I'm going to open it now. More water, come on. Just roll out the opening. And voila, yeah, my clothes are dry as they were before. My favorite sports blouse, yeah, it's pretty dry actually inside, so that's cool. It really works. The waterproof rating is not a hoax, you know, it's fully dry. So that's cool enough, so now I can go on a hike with this dry bag without having to worry that my belongings will get wet. That wraps our video, short video on the topic. So in the next few days, like I said, I'm going to test this dry bag on a hike, on two hikes. The first hike I'm going to do a beach trail, and after that I'm going to do a waterfall hike. Expect my full detailed review on as a blog post on our website europehiking.com. You can find the URL in the description below the video. Make sure to check it out, because there I'm going to explain and share with you my impressions with this dry bag. What are the pros that I found, the cons that I don't like so much, and another useful information related to this dry bag, once I test it, of course. That's it. Thank you very much for watching, for staying with me. Don't mind my accent, and I appreciate if you like this video and subscribe to keep us motivated and do more videos like this. Thanks guys, see you again, bye bye!